Hey, welcome back to the workshop. Today on Force Friday, September 1st, 2017, we're going to be taking a look at new Star Wars kits from Revell. This is going to be Kylo Ren's TIE Fighter. It's a snap tight with lights and sound. It's a build and play kit. It's geared towards kids to build and easily. You can build it with a friend of yours or a kid that you like that likes Star Wars, The Last Jedi, the movie coming out in December. They'd be great stocking stuffers, presents under the tree, birthday gifts, however you want it. This one ran me $19.99 at Target today. I'm going to put it together. Like I said, please remember there's a geared towards kids, but the average modeler can enjoy putting them together as well. So let's take a look inside the box. First up, we've got the black and white manual. There are 20 parts in the kit, of which the manual goes through 11 steps to get that assembled. It is a light and sound, so they also show you how to change the battery. The parts in the kit, we can see the wings on Kylo Ren's TIE Fighter. You can see the detail with the solar panels there. Nice looking, and you can see the size of that kit compared to my hand, and each one of those squares is an inch long. Nice looking, looks just fine. I haven't seen The Last Jedi yet, so obviously I don't have much to compare it to. We can see the main hull, the main fuselage parts, all kinds of cool details in there. They see these are scaled right from the movie. So you can see the nice deep panel lines in there. Now, of course, these can be assembled as is, or you can give them any kind of paint or weathering as you desire. There is what I'm assuming is the engine exhaust on the back. Nice panel lines in that. And the windscreen for the cockpit. Pre-masked and painted, that's helpful. Then we've got the upper hatch, which has also been pre-masked and painted. We've got the rear exhaust deflector, that clear part there. We've got some laser cannons. We've got a little tiny Kylo Ren. Look at him, it's hard to even get him in my fingers. He's not painted or detailed. He's just black. You won't be able to see him very well in the cockpit unless you want to super detail it. Those laser cannons, you get four of those total. You can take a look at them there. Not bad detail on there. Up next are these parts I would assume would be for the wings or the side of the fuselage. They got large locating pegs on them. You get two of those identical parts. And then that exhaust deflector, that diffuser for the light in the back for the engine. We've got four parts here, two of each. You can see these nice side panels for the wings. Let it focus in. Look at that sharp detail. That'll accept a wash real easy just to bring out the panel lines. I'm not going to weather these too much, but I will be applying a wash. If you want to see how to do that, check out either of my Halo kit reviews. That'll show you exactly how to apply a wash to bring out detail so that you can do it to your kits. And then finally, the cockpit with light and sound, and there is a lot described in detail on that. The pilot's chair, the underneath with the battery door and the speaker. Let's listen to some of the sound effects. That sounds just like a TIE fighter. And it sounds just like a TIE fighter shooting from the movie. It's got a third sound effect. We'll listen to that later. I'm going to start assembling, and I will be right back. And just like that, we're all done with Kylo Ren's TIE Fighter. This whole process that you saw in the slideshow, between assembly and applying the wash, we weren't looking at more than about an hour and a half of fun time. If you had anybody that wanted to learn how to assemble a model and wanted to learn how to apply a quick wash to get it to enhance some of the panel line detail, this is a great model to start with. It's inexpensive. It relates to a movie that's coming out, a huge franchise like Star Wars. It looks cool, and it has high playability. You can see that panel line wash just brings out all the detail that Revell has molded in to all the different plastic parts inside and out. And, of course, you can chase each other around the house with this super cool light sound action and playability. So thanks for watching. I'm going to start working on another Force Friday kit that I want to put up today. Stay tuned.